always been a gamer. Recently, I became a teacher, and now I'm a researcher. And my PhD research question is, how do students experience, think, and learn when they use video games and virtual reality as literature in the classroom? Now, this all started because I've been teaching for 7 years, and every year I battle with kids about reading and writing, and we do a project called the My History with Literacy Project. And every year, they come to the conclusion of two things. One, Mr. Harvey, I hate reading. Two, where are the video games? So it made me go to the literature. I wanted to know where they were myself. I played video games my whole life, and I never used one in K through 12 education ever. And so I wanted to make that change. So I looked at the research, and you can see from the quick facts a few things I learned. Like, the average age of a video game player is 36 years old. And the average age of a teacher in this country is now 37. And so for the first time in history, we have a chance to kind of bridge the gap. And the fact that, 20% of our population plays video games, students, research says up to 4 hours a day, it makes me pretty upset when my students won't do their reading log for 30 minutes a night. And I thought, well, maybe they're doing their reading log. Maybe their video games are constituting literary practice. Maybe I should go figure out a little bit more about what's going on. So I made a research study, and I said, listen, students, I need you to help me. I need you to let me know what's important about playing video games. And what can the rest of the world know about video games, and how can we relate that to literature? Because there's such a gap between what students read at home and what they end up doing in school. And I feel that that is such a disparity that we just, in pure obstinance, say, nope, video games do not work here. And I think that is absolutely wrong. So I made a research study, and I wanted 19 of my students to break up into four groups. They played four different games on four different consoles with a variety of age. We had Nintendo 64, we had the PlayStation VR, Xbox, PlayStation 3, to kind of get a wide variety of time. And every day we game for 45 minutes, and we would then look at that, write out what we thought was important, and then every 5 days we'd come back for a research meeting, and we would talk about these themes that seemed to be emerging from our research. And what came to be was that the act of playing a video game is an act of literacy, and that when you engage in these types of themes, feelings and thoughts, bonding to characters, game summaries and evaluations, we find that video games are going to help close the literary gap for 75 million students in this country.
Miles, I want to talk to you.
It's okay. What's up?
Where do you teach, Miles?
I teach at James Monroe Middle School, UNM, and CM.
All right. Great. And where are you from?
Albuquerque, New Mexico.
Terrific. How long have you? You said you've been teaching in
for
7 years.
Sweet years, I might say.
What's the most frustrating thing about teaching?
We have 3 minutes for this response. I think students coming to the classroom feeling that they're not capable.
And the most rewarding thing?
Making them realize how capable they are.
Oh, great. Thank you, Miles.